Oh, hey, Fossil, didn't see you there. It's me, Parker Bennett. Whew, smell that? It smells like Thanksgiving. You know what that means. It's time to quiz Fossil students and teachers on what they know about the holiday. Now remember, the goal isn't to make anyone look stupid. It's to have fun. Let's go, Ridge.
I'm Daniel Saunders.
I'm Brooke.
Hi, Brooke.
I'm Tate.
Morgan.
Ethan.
I'm Miss Plank.
So, for our first question, which of America's founding fathers wanted the national bird to be the turkey?
Benjamin Franklin.
That is right.
Oh, that was like Benjamin Franklin, right?
Any guesses?
Ben Franklin, I guess?
Yep, that's exactly right.
Oh.
Sweet.
Oh.
This is kind of a hard question. What year was the original Thanksgiving in? So, okay, it was 1620-something is your hint. So it's between 1620 to 1629. What? Which American president declared Thanksgiving a national holiday?
Couldn't tell you.
And no guesses at all?
Nope. I would say Abraham Lincoln.
That's right.
Really?
That's actually who it was.
Oh, God. Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
Not quite. This one was Abe Lincoln.
Okay. Awesome. Killing it.
What other country celebrates Thanksgiving?
Canada?
Yep, that's right. And can you name one of the foods served at the Thanksgiving dinner? The original one?
Pumpkin?
Not on this exactly, not pumpkin.
Oh.
Some of the things that were served were deer, other types of fish, and some flint corn. Doesn't that sound appetizing? And then just a final question, what are you thankful for this year?
This year, I am thankful for my job at FRHS, which I love very much.
My friends and family. Friends.
I'm thankful for my family.
Even though everyone may not know everything there is to know about the holiday, they can still be thankful. Remember to be thankful this year, Fossil, and have a great Thanksgiving. Bye.
And have a good day, folks.
Oh, hi, I'm Jim. I love Thanksgiving, but I don't love the awkward conversations that happen between the family. It's kind of, what's the word? I guess awkward.
Do you have a girlfriend yet?
Of course, we're always going to start with the most unavoidable question. So, Aunt Sally, how's your knitting going?
Oh, it's great.
I can always know that she's so self-absorbed into her knitting that I can always distract her from any other conversation she wants to start.
So, what are you thinking about doing after high school?
Great, another one of these questions. No matter what I say, if I tell them my passion, they'll just poke a hole through it, as usual. But if I say I don't know what I want to do with my life, they'll just think I have no motivation. Grandpa, what about your job? I can show a little bit of interest in that. How's that going?
Oh, well, Cindy did this thing where...
Two for two.
Why haven't you been returning my calls?
Great, there's no way around this one. Grandma, I just forgot about you.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bell,
What's up, everybody? Chris Martella coming at you live. Or I guess this is pre-recorded, so it's not live. But anyway, a lot of you might have heard that Homecoming was a little crispy this year, a little burnt around the edges, but that's okay, and I'll tell you why it's okay. Because today I'm announcing we are making that up for you all through a new dance. Yes, you've probably heard before that we're gonna do a makeup homecoming dance. Through a lot of student forums and a lot of polls on social media, we have decided to make a winter formal that is semi-formal that runs from 7 to 10 on December 10th. It's free. Yeah, folks, it's free. You heard it from me, and you heard it from them, and you heard it from over there. It's free. Shout from the rooftop. Woo! Guess what else is free? If you had a guest pass that was approved during homecoming week and you'd like to bring that guest back, do it. They can come for free as well. Holiday. Under the mistletoe formal.
Chris, you get everything wrong. It's not called Under the Mistletoe, it's called Winter Wonderland. Of course you'd think it was Under the Mistletoe. Oh, you can't do anything right. Jeez.
Rings a bell. It rolls off the tongue nicely, don't you think? Yeah. You heard it right here, folks. It's gonna be a holiday-themed, semi-formal dance.
Jingle bells.
I believe the Unified team deserves more recognition because they are amazing. They play with heart and enthusiasm, and everybody should play like that.
And our Unified teams should be supported as equally as every other athletic team, and we should have students come out to all the events, whether it's a drama event or a theater event or a musical event or an athletic event. I think every student who participates here at Fossil Ridge deserves to be recognized.
What does coaching the Unified team bring to my life? I guess just probably joy. It's just one of those, I guess, rare opportunities that a lot of people don't get to experience where it's just something that you're always happy doing. There's never, you know, stress or frustration or anger or any of that stuff. Don't get me wrong, we're still very competitive, but it's just joy. It's so fun to see. The kids have so much fun and get excited about making a basket or a touchdown or anything like that. And they're happy to be there every day, which really rejuvenates you and then makes you want to be there and excited to be there and be with them.
You know, it's, I think it's more than thankful. It's something that of a grace. It's something that I can't give back to. It's something I would love to, absolutely. She came from Cruz Elementary, which I didn't think there would be a better school than that. And then she went to Bolts Middle School. And I was like, okay, there's no way there can be another or a better school than that with better paras and so forth and student help. And then she comes to Fossil and it's just, I don't want her to go to college now. I don't want her to ever leave this school.